Breast cancer is one of the commonest cancer in women in Uganda today. But according to Dr. Noreb Mugisha, the head of Comprehensive Community Program at the Uganda Cancer Institute, breast cancer affects men too.
1% of all men in the world suffering from breast cancer is a man. And at any one time here at Cancer Institute, we have a man we are treating for breast cancer.
The Uganda Cancer Institute currently has over 40,000 patients undergoing treatment. Efforts to increase awareness about breast cancer are underway, and October is the month globally recognized as the Breast Cancer Awareness Month. But are Ugandans really aware about breast cancer?
Breast cancer, it affects the breast of women.
Does it also come to us men?
Actually, I just heard from someone telling me that you feel pain in your breast. That's all I know about breast cancer.
In 2016, the Uganda Cancer Institute registered an increase of over 4,000 cancer patients, of which 1,500 succumbed to the disease. Dr. Noreb Mugisha attributes the increased cancer deaths to the late reporting for treatment by cancer patients.
Many Ugandans come to hospital when they have pain, not just pain, but unbearable pain. And with cancer, if you wait for pain, and especially unbearable pain, you'll come when the cancer is late.
The late reporting, however, could be because Ugandans will always find an excuse to postpone vital health checkups.
I don't get time. Then again, I don't see where they test.
I'm a plumber. I go less times to the hospital, so I don't know. And at our village, there hasn't been anything to talk about the breast cancer stuff.
Because I've never seen any sign of breast cancer, so that's why I've not gone for a checkup.
53-year-old Elsie Luswata is one of the few breast cancer survivors. Like many others, she went for a detailed health checkup at Uganda Cancer Institute after feeling a lump in her right breast while having a bath. This was back then in December 2014.
There were so many thoughts that went through my mind. In fact, I cried a bit and I was told that I had cancer. I was so shocked. I was scared. So many thoughts went through my mind. I knew I was dying.
Luswata's right breast was cut off to save her life. She says her family was shaken by the news of having breast cancer, but was supportive along the way. However, the teacher by profession faced a lot of stigma at work to the point of losing her job.
I remember I had sores in my mouth and I had to go and stand before a classroom and teach them and pretend as if I was well. It was not easy. Then, due to that sickness, I missed some 2 lessons. When I missed the 2 lessons, my employers called me to the office and told me they didn't want to terminate me, but that I should resign my job.
Unfortunately, the cause of breast cancer is still unclear. What is known, though, are the risk factors that expose one to breast cancer.
Its main risk factor is family history. It runs in families. So if somebody comes from a family where an individual has suffered from breast cancer, chances are this person could have a gene responsible for breast cancer. The second risk factor for breast cancer is obesity or high body weight.
Dr. Mugisha also cited not breastfeeding and alcohol consumption as other risk factors of breast cancer. Breast cancer patients normally undergo 4 modalities of treatment depending on the stage of cancer. These include surgery to remove the cancer tumor if it's detected early, chemotherapy, where cancer drugs are injected into the body through a blood vessel, where the part that has breast cancer is exposed to high energy radiation to destroy the cancer cells, and hormonal therapy, where hormonal drugs are given to patients to block the receptors for estrogen and progesterone hormones. The good news, however, is that breast cancer is curable. And more good news is that the treatment is available at Uganda Cancer Institute free of charge.
We have all those services within, and then also the awareness. The screening and the awareness is also done here on a daily basis.
The fight against breast cancer is on, and Ugandans have been urged to initiate cancer awareness services at Uganda Cancer Institute for the communities that could have been left out.
We also have the Comprehensive Community Cancer Program, where we move into communities. We have a schedule for moving into communities, but if you feel the Cancer Institute is being slow into getting into your community, please initiate, we shall come.
Victoria Namtewi, Aban TV.